Hey, happy Monday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman. Plus, we have a big, rare summer cold front passing through that's going to change our weather and make it extreme, even with the temperatures. So I'm going to show you the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long with my weather forecast. And make sure you click the bell. That way you get all the latest updates. Now let's get into your information. Remember, timestamps are always in the description below. And thank you to everyone that helps share this information. Let them know what is coming around the corner. Now yesterday was a very powerful day. All around the whole lower 48, we had 160 wind damage reports all the way from Arizona, all the way over towards northeast by New Jersey. And look right here for Ohio Valley and Great Lakes. This is where the most wind damage reports was coming through. Exact same area is right where we're going to have them for today. And it did upgrade just like I told you yesterday. And we did have a potential tornado over here in Illinois. Also knocked out a lot of power as well. I'm sure they'll work on it quickly. But Minnesota, it was at 28,000 this morning. As you look for Illinois, down to 24,000. Ohio, 18. Michigan, 11,000. And Texas still sitting over a quarter million without power right now. As we refresh it, it's gotten a little bit better, but not much. Now you can see when you look way up in your tropopause by your jet stream, you still have all this warm temperatures aloft, but you got this cooler air coming on down. And this is going to help with your severe weather as well, because the cool air likes to sink while you're getting that rising motion coming up from the convection, so it creates your severe weather. But as you keep watching, as we go through the days, it's going to keep lowering, and this jet stream is going to keep getting severe as it lowers, but then the severe weather will go away. We got all this heat building on the west side of the lower 48. And you can see this. You have a huge ridge on the west side of lower 48. You got that big trough that comes on in. Now, after this lowers down, the severe weather coming with the jet stream will start to fade away. But this also will add up to a lot of rainfall along the mid-Atlantic as these storms just train on this jet stream as it changes. And you can also see it stays there for quite some time. Not only with the cool air bringing out below average temperatures, building all this heat. And you can see this when you look at your lower levels, your 850 millibars, a little bit lower down in atmosphere. As you get the severe weather coming through for today and tomorrow, you got cool air coming in, the sinking air, and helping the severe weather get going. But also, all this heat that you have around the south central is going to start moving to the west. All that hot temperatures, big high ridge all the way into Canada, is going to bring all these very extreme hot temperatures on the west side of lower 48. While it cools down on the east side of the lower 48, sticking around for quite some time and bringing anywhere from 5 to 15 degrees below average temperatures. And yes, all the way down to Texas, all the way down to Mexico and the south and the southeast, and keeping y'all very cool for this time of year while you're very much above average on the western side of the lower 48 into Canada, keeping all the heat. So this is going to cool down y'all summer temperatures. It's not going to bring 30s and 40s, of course, because it's just too hot to get that. It is just very rare for this cold front to even come down with all this heat pushing north. So this is going to be a rare cold front coming through, bringing you cooler temperatures. At the same time, the west side is not going to like the temperatures at all. But until then, we still got record heat happening even today. So for your temperatures, you can see you still have over 105 for the central plains, the southwest, 100 climbing all the way up, all the way across the south and the southeast, bringing you all these 90s. But with the dew points, remember, the humidity is going to be the worst part. Now it brings up feels like temperatures all the way to 100 and 105 plus, all the way across the southeast and mid-Atlantic, all the way towards Jersey and the southwest. Now that's today, Monday. Now as we go towards the end of the week, as it starts transitioning further down, as we go into Friday, you're gonna start getting cooler temperatures overnight now. And for your daytime highs, it is gonna get all the way into the 100, all the way into Canada as well. Southwest California, y'all still gonna be very hot, and this is gonna build. But your highs for that day is going to keep y'all in the 70s. Even further towards the south, your highs are going to be in the 70s and the 80s, when you're usually a lot hotter than that. Even with your heat indices, maybe bringing out some 90s in there. But you're still going to be very cool and very much below average temperatures. Normally, when you're cooking over here in the south central for the summer, you're going to be the most below average temperatures kicking in for this cold front. So y'all really going to enjoy this. Also for the upper Midwest, normally you're not this hot and y'all have some very much above average heat coming in, and you're not going to enjoy this neither. also, as this jet stream comes down with this pattern, it is going to bring above average precipitation across the southwest, the south central, all the way towards the southeast and the mid-Atlantic, bringing y'all extra rainfall. But the heat is going to be unbearable. So from the 20th through the 22nd, you have excessive heat. You're in a high watch in all this dark red area. For the center dotted line, you're all the way into the moderate section for your temperatures, and then you have the slight risk on the next one. This is going to be a big heat wave that's going to be kicking in for y'all. Now, as this cold air starts to come down, you can see we still have these storms building up for today, even showing still a chance for a strong derecho bringing damaging winds behind it. So you see the cooler temperatures the storms bring with it, but this is your cooler air aloft up here that's going to keep coming down, bringing the severe weather as we go for Tuesday and maybe a little bit for Wednesday as well. But it's going to stay coming down, bringing you cooler temperatures. But it is bringing that severe weather aspect. So for today, you can see it did upgrade just like I showed you yesterday. You did get a 5% growth chances for tornadoes. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for that. You also have the chances for the wind threat for today. Even a hatched area in this black, chances for hurricane force are stronger. This is where that potential derecho is going to be forming up. And you have the 15% for the intercoastal northeast and the central plains. So here's your cities and states at risk for the damage of winds for today. You also have a hail threat that's coming with today. Remember, the hail threat is mild, like I showed you yesterday. But here's your cities and states at risk for the chances for the hail threat for today. National Weather Service has severe thunderstorms are possible this afternoon and evening across portions of the Midwest, Central High Plains, Lower Great Lakes, and Arizona. The greatest potential for severe gusts is over eastern Iowa into Illinois and Indiana. And you also can see the update with Colorado State University, showing that it could be a little bit more of a 5% going into Wisconsin, southeastern Minnesota, and eastern Iowa. This is like this could change a little bit throughout the day. Also, your chances for the winds. You see your chance for your winds does have that upscale portion over here for Colorado State University, and we do have that hatched area with National Weather Service. And you can see after we go into the afternoon, this is where it really kicks off. Starting off in eastern Iowa, but then it starts going towards southern Wisconsin. You see the bowing out effect in northern Illinois, and this does stretch also for the intercoastal northeast. You get some storms for upstate New York, and you get some storms building over here for the Four Corners for Arizona, some for Wyoming, Colorado, a little bit for Nebraska and Kansas. But this right here, potential derecho going all evening with a lot of strong winds aloft as well, bringing chances for damaging winds and potential chance for tornadoes. QLCS tornadoes, that means quasi-linear convective system. This means it could be just like this, and a whole line could have a tornado all through it. Showing it will weaken down as you go through the morning, but then it will spark right back up for tomorrow. Chances for storms in the northeast, even chances for tornadoes with these cells that pass through, even over here towards a little bit of Pennsylvania and New York. And then you see it does pass for the central plains. You also get some more storms brewing and some from Missouri going through the rest of the evening. So tomorrow looks just as strong as well, just a little bit further to the south as this jet stream goes further and lower. Showing in the update with HRRR is still showing that potential derecho, but it does show that it finally breaks apart later in the afternoon and overnight. So whether it classifies as a derecho, whether it goes long enough and enough high winds with it, then it'll be classified. Either way, you got a big windstorm coming your way. Showing chances for hail could increase also for eastern Iowa, going through southern Wisconsin, a little bit for intercoastal northeast. This right here for North Dakota and Minnesota, this was early this morning. All this blue and green is very small. Once you get to that yellow and that red, that's chances for large hail. Then as you go through for tomorrow, look how it grows again. Chances for hail to come with them storms through the central plains. But the real kicker is going to be these very strong winds aloft coming through for tonight. So as we start in around 6 p.m., almost to 80 knot winds, northern Illinois goes all the way to Indiana, some of Michigan, then it goes all the way towards Ohio and starts weakening down once you go from midnight on. Those strong winds is going to bring potential tornadoes, but definitely going to bring some damaging winds. So here's your setup for today. So you have the 80s going way up towards Wisconsin. A lot of people in the 90s and 100s, even with the heat indices, it's a lot hotter. Matter of fact, I believe you're beating old records over here in the Northeast. But also, do you see your convection? Because all this heat, bringing all this cape, all this energy for this Storms to feed on. Very high convection as you start through the evening and the winds aloft. So all that is helping with convection as well. And you can see also your winds aloft. It strengthens as it goes through the night all the way to midnight, even maybe 1 o'clock before it starts weakening down. Still strong all the way to 2 a.m. It's just not strong like it was earlier. And your dew points are just filling in. You're getting into the high 70 dew points. So what that's going to do is bring all the particulates in the atmosphere and really get these storms brewing. And you can see on the 15-minute increment, HRRR, which is even more accurate, but you can only go so far. And you can see not only does the storms grow for northern Wisconsin into the UP of Michigan, also over here for the intercoastal northeast, but the storm forming for eastern Iowa, going to northern Illinois, southern Wisconsin, you're in that pink on precipitation. This is some thick storms, very strong storms passing through. You even get the white. That's going towards your max level. As that pushes through all evening long, damaging winds pushing right behind that. Matter of fact, I'm showing chances for well over 100 miles per hour possible, and you always tone it down just a little bit. But when you're showing 115, you definitely know 80 and 90 is not out of the question. And that's what HRRR sees. So as we get started first in the evening, as we get those very strong winds aloft, bring your chances for over 100, over 110 miles per hour wind gusts coming with that. Toning that down a little bit, you can definitely expect 80 up to 90 coming with that, maybe even isolated pockets of more than that. As that pushes through all night long, still bringing the 60 to 70 in the brown, 80 in the white, as it goes all the way from northern Illinois, southern Wisconsin, into Indiana, Michigan, headed that way towards Ohio and eastern Michigan. Later on now, another hour or two, it's going to start weakening down. But look at this big pocket of very high winds coming with it. Plus the storms on intercoastal northeast. That's bringing 40 and 50 miles per hour wind gusts with yours as well. Then as we go into Tuesday, it's going to bring more high winds. It'll bring more winds towards the northeast, some more 50 and possibly 60. Chances for tornadoes also. But over here for the central plains, bringing you 50 and 60 coming with those as well. This cold front is really bringing a lot of strong severe weather as it bends that jet stream. So for tomorrow, for Tuesday, you do have a 2% chance for tornadoes for the intercoastal northeast. So far, here's your cities and states at risk. I'll keep you updated. You also have the chances for winds and the chances for hail. The wind threat, of course, is going to be the strongest. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for Tuesday for your damage and winds. And for Wednesday, it's going to be there as well as you get that jet stream bowing out. You have a 5% for severe weather. So far, here's your cities and states at risk. Showing for northern Arkansas, southeastern Missouri, eastern Iowa, Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, Kentucky, West Virginia, and western Pennsylvania, getting the heaviest amount, even a little bit of southern Michigan. And you can see for the northeast, a little bit of Maryland and Delaware also. But for New York, Massachusetts, for New England, it's going to be giving you all that 1 inch plus also. But as you go for the full 7 days of that jet stream steadily coming this way, the storms, look at the buildup expected. So all this purple is all 1 plus, almost 2 inches anyway of rainfall. Look over here for the southwest, your monsoon season. But look over here for South Carolina, North Carolina, and Virginia. All that red is going 3 to 4 inches. All this orange is going 4 to 5. And that dark orange is going anywhere from 5 to 7 inches of rainfall. Showing so far as we go to 5 o'clock, remember this is central time up here. Now you do have your storms moving across the intercoastal northeast. You have them for the UP of Michigan, northern Wisconsin. You see it does bow out a little bit, even bringing chances for winds with those as it goes through the northeast. But this right here is really going to be significant as we go through the evening. Look at the hail course that's moving through that. Not just northern Wisconsin and the UP of Michigan. You can see the storms that y'all get as well. But this right here building for eastern Iowa going to northern Illinois is bringing some very big hail with that. That right there is bringing chances for large hail, especially once you get to that white. Definitely when you're seeing that black. And as you go through the evening, look how it just grows. Bringing a lot of hail with this line of storms as you go through the night, 8 and 9 o'clock. Bring all this bowing out of the winds. And you see also as you're going by 10, still bringing the chances for the hail, but the hail is calming down now. Now you have the chances for slight chances for the QLCS tornadoes, but you got the damage and wind event that is really going to be kicking with that. And that's going all the way to 10 and 11 o'clock. Now you got some of the hail cores coming back a little bit as it goes through Michigan. As you go through midnight, still there. As you go all the way to 1 o'clock, this is where it starts weakening down and spreading out. after that. And you do have your storms for Wisconsin and UP of Michigan. It is bringing chances for hail with that also as you go through the evening, even showing 7 p.m., one of your strongest hours as these storms go by. But this down here is definitely going to cause a lot of power outages to come with these storms. So if you know someone that lives in this area, please share this video to them. Give them the alert of what is popping up. Because if they don't know about it, they're going to wake up with no power and possibly some damage. So please alert people that you do know in this area. Let them know of these storms. This is happening today and tonight. Now, in spite of all these times going on, even the latest news all over the place, everybody knows about it. I want to remind you of what the times we are in. So please don't let your mind be troubled. This is all written before. Matthew 24:6-8. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled. For all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in divers places. All these are the beginnings of sorrows. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Be warned of these storms. I cannot say that enough. This is going to be a serious event later on tonight. Enjoy the cooler temperatures as it comes in, and beware of the heat that is building. Texas, my heart goes out to all of y'all. I do hope that y'all get all y'all power on by the end of the day today. That is what I pray. Remember, y'all, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope He keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Be safe. Don't forget to check on your neighbors and check on your pets. Help someone today.